mother asked me if I wanted to speak in front of for my dad's memorial. And at first I was like, oh, I don't think I can get up and speak. But as time went on, I prayed and asked God, what am I going to say? Because I really started feeling that I needed to say something. God brought to my mind this Proverbs, Proverbs 17, verse 6. Children's children are the crown of old men, and the glory of fathers, or glory of children, are their fathers. And I thought about that verse, and the first part was just grandchildren. And my dad had grandchildren, and he was very proud of them and enjoyed them. And the second part made me think of how when you have a father in your life who is a good father, who has taken care of his family and provided and loved his wife and his children, the children are always very proud of their fathers. That's the one when the bullies pick on them in school. That's when they tell them it's going to take care of them. And my father was very good. He took care of all of us. He provided, and he talked with us. He answered all my questions. We worked together. We took things apart that my mother mentioned, I think, in the thing she wrote. I can't think of its name. So, you'll never be forgotten, and I am very, very blessed to have such a wonderful father. And I wasn't the only one. A friend of his, co-worker, wrote a letter. Mr. Ed Castor, who I've met a few times. And I'm going to try to read this. It's rather long. I'm going to read this the best I can. Ed says, I knew Carl for 50 years. I worked with him and became friends with Carl, and I met him when we worked in Jackson, Michigan at the plant. We continued our relationship after we were both transferred to Florida. We were both support engineers, reading, relating to the design and development of sonobuoys. My dad made sonobuoys which detect submarines underwater for the military. He says, Carl was an RF engineer who was greatly respected by his colleagues. As I grew to know Carl, he became more of a brother to me and not just another colleague. We worked together on many projects, sometimes traveling together. This allowed me to see another view of Carl, his honesty, hardworking, reliability. He was willing to work long hours to find a solution for a problem that could not often that could often stop production of what we were working on. We often talked together about family and issues. We had a lot in common. We talked about the dogs and the experience and their experience at doggy daycare. our weekly socializing time was mostly during lunch with our other engineer friends. Carl grew to be recognized for his ability to solve problems. He became a project engineer overseeing other engineers and served on several projects. Carl enjoyed traveling and testing, traveling to the testing locations, which I remember that. He enjoyed traveling to all the different places. Carl spent a lot of time in places like St. Croix, San Clement Island, he left. He was highly respected by the technical directors of all these sites. Spartan often sent Carl because our customers had confidence that he, that his opinion was important and related relative to defining the problem. On one trip, Carl traveled to the south of France where he helped. Yeah, I see what you mean. Some of it, it tells of Carl's, my dad's, ability to solve problems, to work with others, and to make hard decisions. And that sometimes costs the customer extra money, but in the long run, solve the problem. The two of them were very close, and they talked about other issues. His failing health, even though my dad's health was failing, Ed said that he remained positive and upbeat during all the time. And he's very sorry for the passing, and he's very glad for the friendship they had together. Thank you for this time.